Hello. Can you folks hear me?
Yes, we can. Right. Hear you very well.
Stunningly well.
Yeah, very well.
All right, and I'm not sure what happened, but all right, I apologize for the technical difficulty. We'll call the Tuesday, January 19th meeting of the San Jose County Board of Commissioners to order. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for a prayer.
Dear Heavenly Father, we ask for your guidance and blessings, and we thank you that you are the source of all our true joy in life. Help us to find our joy in you. May your voice sound clearly above all others as we move forward. May your peace be in our hearts, your grace be in our words, your love be in our hands, and your joy be in our souls. We want your love to surround us, your spirit to guide us, your place to calm us, and your wisdom to arm us. Please lead us wherever you want us. In our Lord, and we pray, amen.
Amen. All right, first order of business, opening reading of bids. It appears there are none. Move on to reports and requests from the Board of Commissioners. First item is the accounts payable docket. Is there a motion?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion to second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Motion passes. Next, moving on to bills passed by the St. Joseph County Council at a public hearing held on Tuesday, January 12th. The County Council took the following action. Ordinance R121, which was Bill 12420, which is cash and reserve policy, to update that. Ordinance 1221, Bill 12620, updating for the coroner's office. Ordinance 221, which was Bill 221 for the health department, as well as Ordinance 321, which is Ordinance 321, which is Bill 321 for the health department. Ordinance 421, which is Bill 721, the monthly transfer and appropriation. And finally, Ordinance 821 was Bill 12520, PSAP Collective Bargaining Agreement. Are there any questions or comments regarding any of these items?
Negative.
Hearing none, is there a motion?
A motion to approve these ordinance R1-21, 1-21, 2-21, 3-21, 4-21, and 8-21.
Second.
Pardon me, we have a motion to second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion passes. Moving on to adult probation, request approval to apply for grant through partnership for a drug-free SJC.
Good morning, Jesse Carlton with the Adult Probation Department. Office is located here on the fourth floor. We are requesting approval to apply for grant funds through the Partnership for Drug-Free St. Joe County. This is a grant that we've applied for in the past. It helps to enhance the drug testing abilities in our lab for folks that are in our problem-solving courts, which includes our drug court and our veterans court. And it also allows for lab and treatment scholarships for those that are indigent and may have issues paying for those fees. Be happy to answer any questions if there are any.
Are there, in fact, any questions for Jesse or comments? Hearing none, is there a motion?
Yes, there's a motion to approve to apply for this grant through partnership for, hopefully, a drug-free St. Joseph County.
Second.
Motion to second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion passes. Moving on to the auditor, request approval of emergency rental assistance funds, Department of Treasury.
Good morning. Mike Hammond, St. Joseph County Treasurer with offices on the second floor. We became aware of a possibility of obtaining a grant to help folks who were in danger of being evicted, largely because of the COVID outbreak and the subsequent tanking of the economy. So we're not exactly sure how much money will be available. There's a lot of details we need to work out. Corey Shipka has kind of taken the lead on this in my office. She and I have been meeting with providers, you know, folks that in the community who are, you know, either government agencies like the trustees, in particular Sean Coleman, Portage Township trustee, and folks from Real Services, St. Vincent de Paul, and others who as a matter of course, assist people providing, you know, rental assistance. The county, you know, obviously doesn't have that sort of infrastructure, so we're reaching out to those folks and getting some ideas, and then hopefully we would use them to help us bring this program into effect if we're so lucky to get the grant money. So again, there's a lot of details to work out. One of the things that, from my office, I have some concerns, and if we get this money and we're trying to disperse checks, that's gonna put somewhat of a burden on our folks. So we got a lot of details to work out, but we're going full steam ahead to try to obtain this, and we'll work out the details later.
Thanks, Mike. I do want to add that this is, once again, the outstanding work that Mike and John Murphy from the auditor's office and Corey as well. This kind of came as a result of continuing our CARES Act conversations and any way we could bring funding into Sancho County for those folks in most need. We're certainly going to do so, Mike, if it comes down to if we're able to bring in a large sum of money, much like we did with the CARES Act in Corey's position, we may need to bring someone in to help manage that program, because we certainly don't want to have lack of personnel be a limit to making sure that we get money in the hands of people that need it. So thank you very much for all of your work related to this. Any questions or comments?
Just for next steps, if this is successfully approved today, we'll have a series of public hearings as required by statute. The first of those public hearings will be February 9th. We've already prepared notices, sent them to Corey so she can get them in the newspaper to advertise those. So that'll be the public hearing that we take immediately after the hopeful approval of this today.
One more, Mike. How, I guess it would be in conjunction with that, how do people then go through the process and who tabulates that?
In terms of who is eligible and whatnot?
Right, will that be part of the process that?
These are just, I would call these just more perfunctory public hearings, Derek, just
okay.
to follow the statutory process. I think the nuts and bolts of who's eligible, how are those monies accounted for are gonna have to be things the auditor's office works out, probably like township trustees and other folks like that are gonna be in that business. We'll probably need some agreements with them, but.
Yeah, they had it was kind of surprising to me just the amount of information these folks had as related to people who needed this thing. So, I mean, the infrastructure already exists on the non-governmental level, and with the trustees, obviously. So they know who these people are, and people are allegedly habituated to go to these folks for this type of assistance. So that was really good for us to find out. So we'll try to work out the details as we go along.
Okay, yeah, I just want to make sure the people who need it get it instead of people trying to scam and all
doubt,
that.
No doubt. There's one thing, one little interesting piece of this, and that is, and I'm not, you know, casting aspersions on any particular group, but landlords are also can also apply for this. So obviously you want to, have as much scrutiny as you possibly can to make sure that we are not being taken advantage of by someone.
Right.
Yep, thank you.
I just want to say, too, though, we're really applying because this is more of a grant. We got to make sure we get the money. Is that what it says here?
Yeah. So we're trying to get it. It's
based on the size.
Yeah, I mean, they're out over their skis just as much as anyone. So they've got, this money's going to be available. And so we're like, okay, what do we do? Well, we'll get back to you on that. So how do we apply? We'll get back to you on that. And then slowly but surely they're unveiling to us. And Jamie's been doing a good job working with Corey in terms of, you're trying to work out of the details, but we're getting there. We're going after it really hard.
Good.
Mm-hmm. Just like CARES Act, we'll figure it out.
Yep.
A bunch of money.
That's what you do.
How to the best ration and how to do it legally, and we'll do that with this money as well.
Exactly. Thank you.
Any other questions or comments? Is there a motion?
A motion to approve this grant application for the Emergency Rental Assistance Fund through the Department of Treasury.
Second.
Motion is second. Of those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 opposed? Motion passes. Thanks again, Mike and Jamie, for helping facilitate this process. Next, County Police request approval to purchase police vehicles.
Good morning, Dean Chandler, 4141 West Lathrop Street. I'd like to purchase 16 vehicles. 9 of them will be police Ford Interceptors for patrol. 7 of them will be Escape hybrids for non-patrol functions. The exact total will be $498,170. That does include a $50,000 hybrid grant from the Indiana Office of Energy. And for Mr. Auditor, that will be paid directly to Jordan Ford. We don't touch that money. That is all I have.
Any question?
There is, excuse me, there's 15 trade-in vehicles included in this paperwork.
So, Dean, we getting $14,000 for the trade-ins?
Yes, $14,400.
Is that about normal when you guys trade?
Yeah, because you get wholesale prices, and most of the trade-ins, to be honest with you, are in very bad shape, frame-wise, of rust.
Right. What about how old are they when you guys trade them back? 5 years?
They are anywhere from 2007 to 2011, and they have 160 to 180,000 miles on them.
Rough miles.
Rough miles, yes, sir.
Any other questions or comments? Is there a motion?
Motion to approve the purchase of these police vehicles.
Second.
Motion and second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion passes. Thank you much, Dean, for your continued hard work.
Thank you. I do want to give credit to Major Noonan. He's the one that did get that hybrid grant for $50,000, so that was on him.
Good. Thank you.
Please pass along our appreciation. All right. Moving to the Health Department, request approval to reapply for Local Health Maintenance Fund grant and Indiana Health Department Trust Account grant.
Good morning. This is Amy Rupi, Administrator for the Department of Health with offices on the 8th and 9th floor of the County City Building. We are requesting support to reapply for our two grants through the Indiana Department of Health, the Local Health Maintenance Fund Grant, and the Indiana Local Health Department Trust Account.
Any questions or comments? Is there a motion?
Motion to approve for the Local Health Maintenance Fund Grant and Indiana Health Department Trust Account Grant.
Second.
Motion is second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion passes. Thank you, Amy. All right, moving on to Maintenance Department. First item, request approval of contract with Orkin Pest Control.
Good morning, everybody. Brian Davidson, Maintenance Department, office in the basement of County City Building. This is just simply annual contract renewals for Orkin Pest Control and UniFirst. UniFirst does all of our runners throughout all our facilities.
Any questions or comments on either of these? We'll take separate votes, but we can, are there any questions or comments?
Brian, I appreciate the changes you guys had made to the UniFirst agreement.
What is it?
I appreciate the changes you had made to the UniFirst agreement, making it applicable to Indiana law and its non-renewal, so thank you for doing that.
Awesome. All right. Well, then, is there a motion on the Orkin Patrol contract?
So moved to approve the contract.
Second.
Motion second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Next, the contract with UniFirst. Is there a motion?
Motion to approve the contract with UniFirst.
Second.
Motion a second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Thank you, Brian.
Thank you.
All right, moving on to infrastructure planning and growth. First item is the consent agenda. We'll note there is an irrevocable letter of credit Audubon Woods Section 2, irrevocable letter of credit cash in Fernwood Subdivision Phase 3, and letter of credit cash in Cloverleaf Farm Subdivision Section 3. Any questions or comments related to any of these items? Is there a motion?
Motion to approve this consent agenda.
Second.
Motion is second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion passes. Next, request proof of local public agency utility reimbursement agreements.
Good morning. Jessica Clark, County Engineer and Department of Infrastructure Planning and Growth, with offices on the 7th and 11th floors of this building. Before you is our final utility reimbursement agreement for our Douglas Road project. It is with AEP to relocate their facilities along our federally funded Douglas Road Corridor project. The estimated reimbursement total is $1,565,359, with our 20% share of that being $313,071.80. We request your approval of the reimbursement agreement.
Any questions or comments? Is there a motion?
Motion to approve this reimbursement agreement.
Second.
Motion is second. Favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion passes. Next, request approval of Bendick Wood CP Navistar Proving Grounds Drainage Project Perpetual Easement, Stormwater Management Easement.
Good morning, Bill Shaleo, Economic Development, with offices on the 7th and 11th floors, part of the Department of Infrastructure Planning and Growth. Before you today is a perpetual easement for the stormwater management improvements that were made on the Navistar Proving Grounds property as part of the Bendix Woods Navistar Proving Grounds Drainage Project. We were here in August asking for your approval to do a right of entry and a right of access. That allowed us to get onto the property to do the work. What we're asking for you to do today is approve this perpetual easement that puts in place an easement over those improvements made on the Navistar site, allows us the access to get on and off their site if we need to make improvements or make modifications to those improvements, and allows for maintenance. If there's any questions, I would be happy to answer them.
Are there in fact any questions or comments for that matter? Is there a motion?
Yes, a motion to approve the Bendix Woods and Navistar Proving Grounds Drainage Project Perpetual Easement.
Second.
Motion second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion passes. Thank you, Bill, again, for your continued work in a project that truly does help not only the private sector in Navistar, but also Bendix Woods on an issue that's been ongoing for a number of years. So thank you for seeing this through. Next, meeting pleasure, we have an add-on request for acceptance of final inspection on B37351, number 62, replacement on Walnut Road over Yellow Bank Creek.
This is Jessica Clark again, County Engineer, offices on the 7th and 11th floor of this building with Infrastructure Planning and Growth. Before you is the report of final inspection and recommendation for acceptance for this project for our bridge replacement on Walnut Road over Yellow Bank Creek. We recommend your approval.
Any questions or comments?
Negative.
Is there a motion?
Yes, a motion to approve this request for acceptance of the final inspection and replacement of the Walnut Road over Yellow Bank Creek.
Second.
For the bridge replacement. Yep.
We have a motion second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Opposed? Aye. Opposed? Motion passes 3-0. Thank you, Jess. Moving on to old business, seeing none. Public comments. I will note that a press release went out and I saw it picked up by many media sources, but just a reminder that the County City building is not closed, completely closed at other county properties, but for all intents and purposes, it is we're limiting access to the public, recommending that you call, email, go to the website to conduct business. The county, along with the City of South Bend, are kind of tying the measures of when to begin to reopen to the state and kind of the color code right now. St. Joe County, thankfully, has remained in orange when most of our surrounding counties have moved to red. And I think that is a strong statement to the great work that our local community is doing, especially the health department, in taking measures that will increase keeping us safe. But just a reminder to folks that the building and properties will remain, for the most part, closed for the foreseeable future. Any other public comments? I will also note a congratulations to the Kansas City Chiefs for pulling one out, and hope Mr. Mahomes can get healthy.
He's fine.
All right. If there are no more public comments, the motion to recess is in order.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Tough luck. We are recessed. Thank you all.
See you later, guys.
Yeah.